Judge Claude Frollo is our villain in The Hunchback of Notre Dame, but what makes him relatable to the world that we live in and what showcases his true evil is his abuse of religious power. On this channel, we do history videos and in-depth analysis, just like this video. So if you're interested in seeing more, hit the subscribe button and maybe hit that bell notification just so you get notified when we put up new videos. Religious or spiritual abuse has been going on for centuries. We've had the witch trials in Salem. We've had slavery. We've even had sacrifices to volcanic gods. But something that still goes on today that fits that mold of religious abuse is psychological. I'm not damning religion. A pastor of decades wrote in his 2001 book, Religious Abuse, "The religion is the institutional expression of a divine human encounter. And because the human beings that make up that institution are imperfect, the community they create will have the capacity not only to bless, but also abuse those who are a part of that community." Religion is an imperfect community, and people within that community will use it and abuse it for power, and such is the story of Claude Frollo. In Victor Hugo's original novel, Claude Frollo isn't a judge, he's an archdeacon at Notre Dame. And despite the change in Disney's depiction, Claude Frollo uses religion as a heavy influence against Esmeralda and especially Quasimodo.
"What? I am to be saddled with this misshapen? Very well. But let him live with you in your church."
"Live here? Where?"
"Anywhere."
What's interesting about Keith Wright's quote from his book is that we really think of religion and religious places as safe spaces. These spaces would be filled with people who are honest and open, and those followers follow their church and those leaders with blind faith. It's in this context that the story becomes scary. We shouldn't follow anything, especially religion, with blind faith. It's just not a good practice to have. We should be skeptical and question everything. It's in those times that we don't, that villains sneak their way into our governments, our religions, and our lives. So how does Claude Frollo use religion and become one of Disney's most evil villains? It's actually through his language. Joseph Piper, the German philosopher, says in his book, Abuse of Power, Abuse of Language, "Tyranny, propaganda, and mass media destroy and distort words. They offer us apparent realities whose fictive character threatens to become opaque." Frollo not only uses the Cathedral of Notre Dame, this safe space and a sanctuary for Quasimodo, but he uses his words to distort Quasimodo's worldview. He even sings a song about it.
"You are deformed.
I am deformed.
And you are ugly.
And I am ugly.
And these are crimes for which the world shows little pity. You do not comprehend.
You are my one defender.
Out there they'll revile you as a monster.
I am a monster.
Out there they will hate and scorn and jeer.
Only a monster."
In the HBO documentary Mother Dead and Dearest, we meet a girl whose mother tells her she's sick and is kept sick on medications, distorting her worldview, keeping her down through the sickness, just as Frollo keeps and contains Quasimodo in the Cathedral of Notre Dame. It's often stated that we should fear God, and depending on your religion, that might be true, but using that fear to deceive people, to distort their worldview through words and through power, is really abusive and psychologically damaging. And that power also creates ego. Claude Frollo would rather burn Paris to the ground than admit to his own wrongs and sins in his lust for Esmeralda.
"I feel her, I see her, the sun caught in her raven hair is blazing in me out of all control. Like fire. Hellfire, this fire in my skin, this burning desire is turning me to sin."
And I'm not saying that sinning is right or wrong. We all have sinned, we all have our own vices. And we've all made mistakes, but using religion to hide your own personal mistakes and to keep others down with words and power is truly an act of pure evil. What Claude Frollo does in the story of the Hunchback of Notre Dame is psychologically damaging to Quasimodo, and it's a true act of selfishness on the part of our villain. So what can we learn from the Hunchback of Notre Dame and Judge Claude Frollo? For those of you who maybe aren't religious, and maybe you think that religion is evil, it isn't. But it also isn't perfect. And for those of you who are following religion or some sort of god, we shouldn't follow our leaders in our church blindly. We should question everything, and especially question those in power. Well, let me know what you think about Judge Claude Frollo. Do you think that he's the most evil villain in all of Disney? Are we sympathetic to a character like Claude Frollo because he seems more human? Or is he simply a lost cause? Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below, and make sure to check out everything that we've got going on over at network1901.com. We've got videos, podcasts, and of course, t-shirts, stuff that you can see like right here. And also, myself and Angie do Modern Mouse Boutique full-time, so if you want to check out one of our hats or maybe a pair of mouse ears, you can check out one like right here. And in the meantime, thank you for watching, and keep on moving, people.